Alright, now that we've wired up the front end of the trailer, we're going to get to the rear end. And as you can see, I've got the two original tail lights here. And when you take them apart, take them off the trailer and look at them, you can see there's rust in there and corrosion. And all this leads to bad grounds, which the outside metal part of the light bulb is the ground. Of course, the center tap, and in this case, two center taps because there's two filaments in there. One is running lights, one is brake and signal lights. The other one is running lights. Actually, you could do this any combination you want, depending on how bright you want what, but we'll get into that later. But this wire, the insulation is cracking, it's old, it's coming apart, and it's going to want to short out. See right there? It'll short out against the metal casing, which is ground. You don't want the hot shorting out to that, so we're going to have to replace that wire. The first thing we got to do is get rid of this corrosion so that we can get these bulbs out of here easily without ruining anything. So that's our first order of business. So what you want is some PB Blaster. This is penetrating catalyst. It breaks things loose. It's like a penetrating lubricant. Just works good on all kinds of things. The secret to using this stuff is allowing it to sit for a bit. You don't need to use a lot, just let it sit for a bit and do its job and then come back and work it a little bit. I've used this on all kinds of things that were rusted shut, and with enough elbow grease and patience and this stuff, I've been able to break things loose that other people would have thrown away. So what we're going to do, shake this up. I got 100 parachutes opening over me right now. That's what you just heard. They're doing 100 ways across the street, but they open right over my house. At any rate, shake this up real good. And we're going to spray just enough on the rusted parts here where we need to get rid of this rust and we need to get this broken loose so that we can get this bulb out of here. We'll spray a little bit on there. Same on the other one. There's a spring inside there. You want to get that wet too, if you can, getting through the slots. Then we're going to just let that sit for about, 20 minutes, maybe 15 minutes. All right, it's been about 10 minutes and it's looking a little dry, so I'm going to spray a little bit more in there. Let it soak in. Right, I think this one that was a little cleaner is about ready to come out. I'm going to try that one because the other one's going to take a while. It's, as you can see, that rust is taking a while to dissipate. So this one, I'm wiggling a little bit. Just kind of wiggling it. And now I'm going to push down on it a little bit, back and forth, kind of wiggle it. Call this the jiggle method. Never force anything. It's starting to move. There, I can actually see it and feel it moving. So we can get it to go down far enough, we can turn it. Because those pegs are sticking out. We'll turn in that slot. I'm going to get a paper towel. See, that's moving. Should be able to get it now. I'm going to get a paper towel so I can get a grip. Okay. Kind of clean it off a bit and get a grip on it. Just keep jiggling it. It should come loose. And if worse to worse comes, you can use a needle nose possibly on the metal part. Let's try that. Okay, I'm just going to grab it. I'm going to push down on it and turn, and that worked. See, there it is. So now we'll probably do the same thing with the other one, just jiggle it, spray some more stuff on it. You don't want to squeeze too hard. You don't want to make it out of round. It's just not ready yet. It's not jiggling enough yet, so it needs a little bit more stuff. a little bit more time, a little bit more patience. So we'll put some more stuff on it. Let the PB Blaster do its work. A little longer. Okay, it's actually wiggling now. The metal part is actually wiggling, so I'm going to see if it'll come out. Yeah, we'll grab a hold of it here. Push down on it. I don't know yet. It's wiggling. It's wiggling. Let's keep working it like this. You didn't see that, but I cracked the bulb. Squeezed just a little too hard, but it should be, it's wiggle loose enough, I should be able to get it out now because I can grab it. Now you want to clean the inside of those sockets real good with like a little wire brush, a little tiny wire brush, toothbrush, something like that. Okay, I've been trying to get this in the right light here. Wrong part of the day for this. What we're going to do is take the center tap doohickeys here out. If you're looking at it in this direction, remember that the duals are on the right and the single is on the left. I'm going to take these out, set these over here to dry, and if you're like most handy people, you have one of these wire brushes for cleaning your battery terminals, and you can kind of get that in there and play with that for a while. If you don't have one of these, get a little toothbrush, a little brass type wire toothbrush, get it down in there and clean it. That's what I'm going to do, but I'm going to have to go get one because I can't find the one I used to have. But this kind of works, but I don't think I'm going to be able to get it all the way down in there. There are springs down in there, so don't lose those. But you want to clean that out. Actually, this is working pretty good now. You want to clean that out so you get a good ground. There's the spring. I'll put it back in after it, after I'm done cleaning this. So that's actually working pretty good. Get in there and turn it. It takes a while. I'll do that to both of these, and we'll put the springs back in, put them back together, and rewire it.